says you gotta be rooted and grounded. On the flip side of being rooted, look at what he says about grounding. Trustee, you're an engineer. To ground something, he's given a contrast here, if you will, a metaphor. He says, I want to look at it now, and aside from looking at it from a harvest perspective, look at it now from a construction perspective. You're building something. And any electrical engineer knows that you got to make sure that what is grounded. If it's not grounded, you plug something in, somebody gonna get fried. Amen? So what's Paul saying to us? That if you don't take time to cultivate your relationship with God, making sure that you are rooted and grounded in love, first of all, you're not going to experience the fullness of God. I don't care how often you show up at the church. I don't care how faithful you are. I don't care how melodiously you sing. I don't care how dynamic you are in preaching. I don't care if you are not cultivating love. You will not experience the fullness of God. Now, I know y'all mad. I know you're mad, so let me prove it. If you look over into the 13th chapter of the first letter written to the church at Corinth, you can't get through this Christian walk without loving. And it means loving more than God. When you love each other, you demonstrate your love to God. You cannot come in here and tell me how much you love God, falling out in the floor and screaming and hollering and jumping up and down. I love God, but you can't stand your brother. You are not going to walk in the fullness of God. Paul said in the 13th chapter of Corinthians, though I speak with the tongues of men and of angels and have not charity, love